When you get a spectroscopy problem on a test, you're often given the molecular formula and asked to determine the structure of the molecule. And sometimes the hydrogen deficiency index can be useful for figuring out the structure of your molecule. Let's start off by looking at hexane. So here we have hexane with a molecular formula of C6H14. We say that hexane is completely saturated with hydrogen, so it has the maximum number of hydrogen atoms possible for the number of carbons. So if we have 6 carbons, 14 is the maximum number of hydrogens that we can have. And remember, when you're talking about alkanes and you have n carbons, you get 2n plus 2 hydrogens. So here n is equal to 6, so we have 6 carbons, so 2 times 6 plus 2 gives us 14 hydrogens. Let's compare hexane with 1-hexene. So now we have a double bond present, and that changes the molecular formula, of course. So now the molecular formula is C6H12. We have the same number of carbons, 6, but we have 12 hydrogens. And up here we had 14. So we're missing 2 hydrogens. And so we say that's 1 degree of unsaturation, or a hydrogen deficiency index equal to 1. So an HDI equal to 1. So it's like we're missing 1 pair of hydrogens here. Let's look at cyclohexane. So here we have cyclohexane, and the molecular formula is C6H12. Once again, we have 6 carbons, but we have only 12 hydrogens. So we're missing 2 compared to hexane. We're missing 2 hydrogens, we're missing 1 pair of hydrogens. So the hydrogen deficiency index, the HDI, is equal to 1. So if you were given this molecular formula, C6H12, right here, it's the same molecular formula, right? And you think about how many hydrogens you're missing from the maximum number. You're missing 2 hydrogens. That's a hydrogen deficiency index equal to 1. Here we had 1 double bond, and here we had 1 ring. So with an HDI equal to 1, one possibility is you have 1 ring. Another possibility is you have 1 double bond. All right, let's look at benzene. So here we have benzene, a molecular formula of C6H6. So with 6 carbons, the maximum number of hydrogens you can have is 14, and here we have 6. So 14 minus 6 is equal to 8. So it's like we're missing 8 hydrogens. So that's 4 pairs of hydrogens. So the HDI is equal to 4. So the hydrogen deficiency index is equal to 4. And I like to think about why the HDI is equal to 4, because, right, if this is 4, we have 3 double bonds here. 1, 2, 3, and we have 1 ring, right? So we have 1 ring here. So 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, and we get an HDI equal to 4. Right up here we had 1 ring, and we had an HDI equal to 1. Up here we had 1 double bond, and an HDI equal to 1. We could also calculate the HDI using a formula. So we could write that the hydrogen deficiency index is equal to 1/2 times what's in the parentheses, which is 2 times number of carbons plus 2. That's the whole 2n plus 2 idea, minus the number of hydrogens. So let's go ahead and do it for this molecular formula with 6 carbons and 6 hydrogens. So let's plug in those numbers. So we have 1/2. This would be 2 times number of carbons, that's 2 times 6, plus 2 minus number of hydrogens, that's 6. So let's do the math. So this would be 1/2. 2 times 6 plus 2 is 14, minus 6, 14 minus 6 is 8, times 1/2. We get an HDI equal to 4. So if you have a spectroscopy problem and you calculate the HDI equal to 4, think about the possibility of a benzene ring being present in the structure of your molecule. Let's compare benzene to another molecule where we're adding in a nitrogen. So here's benzene, and we know there are 6 hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 hydrogens. Let's add in a nitrogen. Right, so we are adding in a nitrogen. So now we have aniline as our compound here. How many hydrogens? Right, so this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7 hydrogens here. So we've added 1 nitrogen, right, and we get 1 more hydrogen. So we need to modify the formula for HDI. So let's go ahead and do that. So we would write the hydrogen deficiency index is equal to 1/2 times what's in our parentheses, which would be 2 carbons plus 2 times the number of carbons plus 2. And now we're going to add the number of nitrogens that we have. So add the number of nitrogens and then subtract the number of hydrogens. So let's go ahead and do this calculation. So 1/2 times, once again, we have 6 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 2 times 6 plus 2 plus the number of nitrogens. We have 1 nitrogen, so we add a 1 in here. Minus the number of hydrogens. We said there were 7, so minus 7. And let's do this. This would be 1/2 times, this would be 14 plus 1 is 15. So 15 minus 7 is equal to 8 times 1/2 is equal to 4. So an HDI of 4, right? Remember, an HDI of 4, think about a benzene ring being present in the structure of your molecule. All right, let's do another one. Let's compare benzene to chlorobenzene. So over here on the left, we have benzene, once again, 6 hydrogens. And here we have chlorobenzene. So we've added in a halogen. And how many hydrogens do we have in chlorobenzene? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So only 5 hydrogens this time. So we've added a halogen and we've lost a hydrogen. We went from 6 to 5. So we need to modify our formula again. So HDI is equal to 1/2 times what's in the parentheses, 2 times the number of carbons plus 2 plus the number of nitrogens. So plus number of nitrogens minus the number of hydrogens. And we would also need to subtract the number of halogens. So minus the number of halogens that you have. All right, let's do it for chlorobenzene. So 1/2 times how many carbons we have? Still 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 2 times 6 plus 2, zero nitrogens, right? So zero nitrogens. How many hydrogens? 5 for chlorobenzene, so minus 5. And we have 1 halogen, right? We have 1 halogen here. It's the chlorine, so minus 1. So let's do that math. So we have 1/2 times 2 times 6 plus 2 is 14, right? So we have 14 minus 6 over here. So 14 minus 6 is 8 times 1/2 is equal to 4. So we get an HDI equal to 4. And once again, we think benzene ring. So HDI is equal to 4. We think about a benzene ring being present. All right, let's think about one more example. So if we look on the left, once again, we have benzene. So here's benzene with the 6 hydrogens. And we've added in an oxygen, right? So for this molecule, we've added in 1 oxygen. What happened to the number of hydrogens? So we have 5 on the ring, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then this one, 4, 6. So even though we've added in a hydrogen, there's no change in the number, even though we've added an oxygen, I should say, there's no change in the number of hydrogens. And since there's no change in the number of hydrogens, we don't need to modify our formula here for the hydrogen deficiency index. So I'm going to go right back up here and box this. So this is our final version for calculating the HDI. And you don't have to use this formula every time. Sometimes you can just think about how many hydrogens are missing. But sometimes using this formula allows you to calculate the HDI, which helps you to think about what's present in the structure of your molecule. And so I'll show you several examples of how to use the HDI to figure out your dot structure.